Mafia Kings and Queens. Greetings.
Greetings to the world. Greetings to every single person. Man, woman, child, king, queen, god, goddess, I hope all will refer to yourself in a positive, uplifting manner.
Mm-hmm.
Is that another one where I really like it? But yeah.
Yeah.
We hear every school region.
What we say? We live in the Gael.
Live in the Gael.
With fireball. The one and only.
Yeah. Fireball again. Right with you, child. So, fireball, is he seeing my?
I did, man. You know, looking at some things, looking to back and drive, like juice. Want to start back with the juice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
nah, is this one of the
Well, the name of it was Fireness, but it might have a new name this time.
Okay.
Yeah, and also
coming soon. Let's say
coming soon. Mm-hmm. So that one of the things I'm working on right now. Doing food as well. But the place kinda the food takes that struggle. Mm-hmm. You know, so just
because I just enjoy your soup.
Yeah.
Fire pot.
What? Well, if I tell you all that stuff.
Tell me.
What happened is, before me and Miguel, well, actually, me and my wife, we live together, but she have a place as well. Right? So she invited me for soup. And I told her, be careful. With your soup, because my soup is the best. I mean, I've never tasted it before, but based on what people say, I never tasted it.
Yeah.
People say my soup is the best.
Right.
And when I taste her soup, I was offended. I was offended because she soup tastes better than mine. And I was like, but.
At least you could admit it.
I don't joke with that. I like to admit things. I have songs I didn't like.
Right.
I didn't admit my music is. You know what I mean? If I don't like it, I'll admit it first.
Yeah.
So, when I taste it, I thought, it looked just like mine. Same texture, everything. But something different in this.
Hmm.
And when I tell you what it is, that was it. After that, we tried it.
Nice.
So, we tried it. Let me do some soup. Since your soup is the best, and my soup is the best, and you know what I mean? Let me join together.
Soup plus soup.
The soup went very well.
So, before we get into it, there was no mention of it, but I feel like I have to say it, but because I feel good. All them years ago when I see it, but churning up my son hot.
Yeah.
And churning up how many was today.
Yeah.
Up to the avenue. I said, fire, we just said, because I remember my lasting memory from you in success.
Yeah.
All of you went to school together. Proud past students at
Suffolk.
I'm from 96 here, they're from 97.
Best two years.
Right? I always remember you chanting, Colin chanting, this is where they must see for the legend.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
And I think it was Kyron beating on the desk. And them fellas and them belts in a whole song right here. A whole song on the spot. And the thing songing good, I know. Based on the classroom and them best used to get nice music.
The first one. You know when you hit low on the desk,
I never forget that. Because I really call it as one of the baddest in what he just do. And I really fire. I was one of the baddest in the way to do.
Mm-hmm.
And I went, the two of them went to school together, actually do things together. And then I remember my senior day, a few years after we leave school.
Yeah.
And I didn't know nothing about music and things from Fireball, and which is something I was expecting.
Yeah.
I say, hey, I hope you still doing music now. Do that music now. What? About 2 weeks later, I see the man and Soca Star.
Yeah.
You know? And yeah, I'm working on the big group. I'm not grouping for the money we're not talking
about. Yeah, yeah, exactly.
You know, sure. And then when we knew up with that Soca Star, we just happened.
Yeah, we knew it though.
Yeah.
I could talk it though. I know that was a better idea. For all the Soca Star fans that were talking about their bossy man.
Yeah.
We know about it a long time because we had many art room that are party. We are in the room at a party.
And all you know, things that the fans don't know.
That's right.
You know,
we're going to talk it, give them a better insight. I don't know.
It has some things. It has a lot of people very disappointed in me. Because I never really get to show my true self in the music industry.
Right.
First to begin with, that come late.
Yeah, we know that.
That comes late. My foundation, people don't know nothing about that opera thing.
Yeah.
That happened on the show itself.
Yeah.
You know, I'm a man. Bam, 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 bam. Would you have
put it up.
That also the big boys and them, Bungie, Maximus.
You're like, you're like.
So, at that time, I was working with Kit as well, who was the uncle of the popular producer of Kit as well.
Right.
Those days was Kit as well. Mm-hmm. And when I told Kit as well what I am writing the song to, he said, I've been something similar to it. Right? That was 2002.
Danger.
And when I released Danger, Jason and Blaze, I don't know if Jason was there, but Blaze on 98.9, we backed my song for almost half an hour
straight. Yo, here we got back in
98.9. Yes.
And that was the day. Well, after he released that song for half an hour straight, I never play again. Because trust me, I was on the radio. See, listening. It never play again on that station. So, you know, that went
weird,
but you know,
you free to talk?
We will talk anything. One thing I have to do here is permission.
I'm
like, yes, Sam,
the say you have to say. No, because for me, remember, you was on another show to do years ago called Tentative.
Yeah.
And the reason why Tentative didn't come about was because we see so much of young talent in this place that you never hear on the radio. Yeah. Now, people like to say, you don't need the radio. I do believe that, and I do buy into that.
Yeah.
Right? Because no matter what we say, it has a certain thing with the radio that once you play in the league, you could possibly play everywhere. Yeah. Right? YouTube and all the other social media and streaming apps is still a hit or miss. Right? But once you're on the radio, and we have a technician that we don't support you.
No.
That's just the reality.
Yeah. And we see certain stations play what I will consider garbage.
Level garbage.
Until it's stick in your ass.
Until it's stick in your ass. But I mean, it has also happened with you in the sense of when the soccer season come and certain memories, you know what I mean? The thing playing right you over and over and nonsense. You know? What happened with me is I tried to turn my tribulation into a blessing. Man.
Right.
So, because I wasn't getting no airplay, no matter what I release, before 2006, I wasn't getting no airplay at all. I started writing songs that hit in your one time. So, I started to like, okay, well, they want to give me airplay. When I get opportunity on a stage, I still need to be able to move the crowd.
Right.
But I'm not getting airplay.
Right.
So I have to have something to move the crowd without airplay.
Right.
And that helped my music get better. It helped my writing get better.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so when who feel the big boys now? When me and them bounce up, that was the trouble. It's like, no, we had to do something with this fella. We had to too fast. So.
And we like this thing, this country. Me and you just had this discussion plenty. The Jamaican free state itself, free is not a recommendation. I hate to tell them, please, I ask Richard Laffey, Ogelana, Oguna, they don't believe in that nonsense at all.
Yeah, I know this is.
Because you, especially in all honesty, is the only person who knows you as a certain way.
That is
sad.
Yep.
So, who better to pat you on the back and say, hey, yeah, boy.
That's it.
Yeah, you have to do it, yeah, boy.
Right? But I say, no one on the other side, and I say, if I just listen to your music, forget it, my ass is my friend.
Yeah.
I listen to the music. It's not everything I like.
Yeah.
But what's on earth, like, yo, how does this not make international tune, boy?
Yeah.
Right? So I know people in the industry feel the same way. What is the real fight, though? In your opinion, as somebody in the music, why is the fight not necessary from certain artists, people, and radio stations?
The fight not necessary because people always love to be in control. Is natural human nature. You know, people love to be in control. And the more they be in control, is the more they will be able to succeed. And some people don't watch the bigger picture. They just watch their success, you know? So that identify them. That identify them. What I notice in Trinidad is a lot of people want to be the first. Want to be the first to say, I do this. To say, I do that. You know, when you come and do it for them, all hell is breaking loose. Instead of them joining you and doing it more, making it consistent. Because I remember on Qatar Awards, I spoke about that because I was instructed to do so by my management. They say, fire, when you reach the stage, let the other artists know you want them to join you. And when I say that, they got offended.
You ain't supposed to make that call.
They get offended, The so-called gatekeepers at the time got offended. You know, and that is when I realized, wow, people are petty and small-minded in this place. You know? We have certain people I would not get a break without them getting a break first. Men like Marshall Montano, Atakman, PMC, but Jigalim. I call these particular names because them help change up the thing and bring it to where it is.
Right.
So that opera could have come into the play. Because people was more open-minded due to what these fellas do before.
Right.
So, I come on the scene now, and in the first year, boom, I hit the charts. It could never be because of my talent alone. It's because of the preparation of these fellas and more. Right? Yet, some of these fellas got offended because it's like, I do this so long, I'm thinking of this. Where he come from and this.
But are you kicking or
whatever?
If I see king,
yeah.
I know you worry about a bar and a night. Is I still at that point?
That's right.
And the first year now, people isn't really get out of the first year. Doing well is a rookie that happy for you. It's the second year. When you come back out and Fayan Lions, big up to Fayan Lions. Fayan is the first person who tell me that. Fayan's here. Enjoy yourself. Next year, young man, you will see a fight you've never seen before. Not from me though, but the fight coming.
And why is that? That's absurd. The fact that is a thing.
You know, something we talk about more than once. Add to the kind of layer into what he's saying. I tell them, I go all kind of Jamaican artists show each other on the radio. Sizzla, Anthony B, Beeman, Bumpty, all of them. And one thing nearly all of them have in common is that when they come here, they bring some no-name artists they never hear before. Either the new name artists never make it, or they do not rarely, but they bring in some artists. And you know, for me, I don't know how wrong I is. I do see the soca artists, the big humongous soca artists, I do see them pushing a young artist. Because you can't tell me people don't go up to them and go, hey, Mr. So-and-so. Mr. So-and-so, go check out this, or send an email. We find out, Firewall, why email for so-and-so? I have so many things, and Firewall getting it. Now, you can't tell me, I show them flooded and bombarded. How come we don't see them pushing? All that time we have during the pandemic. All that time we have, right? To me, that was a great time.
To start exposing.
To start pushing younger artists like, check out this Superman. Here is Superman. And I mean, a simple thing as an endorsement from them. So that goes to show what Fire is saying about the mindset now. Because all they're pushing the next generation. Like all they want to be on the walking stick, why not say it all?
Folks, you gotta take a break and come back.
We'll be back.